I'd like to talk to you about a gas chromatograph in the column. Simply put, the column is where the chromatographic magic occurs. It is how the complex mixture of the jumbled mess or stuff, for example, blood, is uniquely separated into its unique parts, hopefully if everything is done correctly. The variables of the column in conjunction with the conditions in the method are that which causes the separation of the complex mixtures. It is what causes the analyte of interest, meaning the target compound you're looking for, to become separate from everything else. Stated a little bit differently, it's how the analyst arrives at the qualitative measure in the analytical process. For example, how you know it is methamphetamine and nothing else. It is primarily a separation based upon boiling point and polarity. You are not expected to understand how that occurs if you're a criminal defense attorney, but you need to be exposed to it. Physically, a column is a coiled tube. What I'm going to describe is that which is most frequently used in gas chromatography that defense attorneys, judges, and prosecutors will encounter in our state crime labs. It's called a capillary column. Technically, it's called a wall-coated open tubular column. Within the inside of the tube is a thin layer coating. This inner coating is comprised of different chemicals in different thicknesses and made up of different compounds. This inner coating is called the stationary phase. Capillary columns are a thin fused silica or purified silicate glass on the outside. They're very small in terms of their inner diameter, usually about the width of a human hair, and typically they're pretty long in terms of their length, measured in meters. What the inner coating or the stationary phase is and its thickness, as well as the length of the column, will determine the ability of that column to be selective or maybe even specific, as well as its sensitivities. The inner coatings, and meaning the stationary phase, are most frequently made up of different chemicals. And what these chemicals do is change the polarity of the stationary phase. The nonpolar end of the spectrum is a particular compound that can be made more polar by increasing the percentage of the phenyl groups in the polymer that's inside the chemicals. For the very polar analytes, polyethylene glycol, aka carbowax, is commonly used as a stationary phase. After the polymer coats the column wall or packing material, it is often cross-linked to increase the thermal stability of the stationary phase and prevent it from gradually bleeding out onto the column. I'd like to give you some definitions, some of the words we used here. Selective. Selectivity refers to the extent to which the method can be used to determine particular analytes in mixtures or matrices without interferences from other components of similar behavior. Selectivity gives us an indication of how strongly the result is affected by other components or compounds in the sample. A selective test may not be a specific test due to cross-reactivity, interference, or co-determination. By sensitivity, we mean the quantitative measure. It is within the linear dynamic range in that the unknown amount does not exceed the limit of linearity, but also exceeds the limit of detection and the limit of quantification. Specific. To be specific, a test that reacts only with the analyte of interest and nothing else, to the exclusion of everything else, so that when there is a measure, it is unique to that which is examined. It is not simply selective, which is an exhibition of a degree of preference for the substance tested, but not necessarily unique. So to be specific is the goal, not merely selective.